Welcome back to Overflow Things. I want you all to think about why you failed today. And we are on a deep metabolic journey. And we all want to improve. We all want to succeed. And the lack of that success is a lack of commitment. You don't keep going. You don't keep fighting. You're going to sink into the quicksand. And now, I'm going to tell you a story. You may have heard the gorilla mindset. And the gorilla mindset is one of the most toxic mindsets of a modern man, because he doesn't think of his future or his past, just in the present. No meaning, no context, just a meaningless man in a meaningless world. But the orangutan, he planned because he could learn language, and he went through the boundary to another species. And now we want to go from slave to free man, a weakling to a strong man. The orangutan mindset must be implemented. We don't want to live in a fairy tale, just like all of those other primates. We want to speak clearly, hear clearly, and feel clearly. Otherwise, it'll just be like when the Spanish came over and killed all those Aztecs. So I want you to focus on your strength, your core, and your voice, and your heart. No more theater boy behavior. First principle of fitness is for every day. What do I mean by that? We need to make sure every day we're overflowing. We're not underflowing. Every day we go beyond those little underachieving actions. And first of all, it's walking. I want you to think, I'm not walking to wage slave. I'm not walking to be a neat. I'm walking to win. Confident, strong, and you overflow. Okay, here's another tip for fitness freaks. We want to wake up like a winner, like a hero, even like a villain sometimes to the bad people out there. So, we don't just wake up like we're in a piece of trash, we wake up for war. With a sit-up, with a few punches. And, of course, everyone's favorite exercise, the burpee. Do it every time you wake up, and do it double. And even do it Googleplex times if you can. That's what I want. And now, I feel the time is needed when we talk about failure. And we need to learn about failure, because how else are we gonna not repeat their mistakes? That is, of course, the three underflows. And the first underflow I want you to talk about, and I want you to tell your parents, and I want you to tell your kids and your friends, but not in a way which exposes yourself to the people which want to bring you down. It's the gorilla. Ultimate symbol of overinflated meaninglessness. And that's why we should not talk about him anymore. I want to talk about the second underflow and the second failure, that is the Aztecs. They were on the floor when they were immediately, so they lost immediately. In a street fight, you never want to hit the floor, because that's when you're at your lowest and you just keep tumbling down. There's no way up. They were beaten by the Bill Gates of college dropouts. Germán Cortés was a dropout and a psychopath. But he was killing psychopaths, so we don't care. But we get the lesson from that. We learn from Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. You need to be able to grapple the enemy and bring them down to your level. And then bring yourself up. And you stay down at their level, you die with them. But you get up and you ascend to a greater form of existence. They only cared about the capital while only caring about capital. We care about spiritualism and meaning. That's the only thing we care about. And if you only care about your Instagram Lamborghini, you end up dying in your Instagram Lamborghini. And it ain't worth shit, because everyone wants a Tesla. I want you to remember that. We want to talk about four stages of history of movement, and this is high level information. So I don't blame you if you don't fully understand, because I don't feel like I fully understand. That's why I'm here today. Look, that's why. If you look closely, you understand. Have a first stage of history. Let me know if we introduce the world of cons. We have a modern man, a being of just attention. And he doesn't understand the world because he understands everything through a tool and just technology. He doesn't understand why. Not even programmers understand the words that they type or the letters that they know. Now, do I understand the camera which is looking at me? Or the men who are looking at me through the camera? No. That's why I want you to understand. First stage of the men of renown. That's the first age, and I want you to do a bit of legwork. A bit more of an exercise, and a bit more than just good. And the second was Baba. The third, that man we all know, Hui Shi Hong, inventor of the Divine King. The man who wants to keep us down, and keep us down there now. And the fourth, that's the age of information, technology, and constant global war. And the war within ourselves. I want you to look at it. And even people in Sudan and Syria today, fighting constant wars for systems they don't understand, and people wasting their lives away in systems they don't understand. And that is the new stage of degeneration, if we fight against, and we reclaim that Spartan spirit of pure strength. Gentlemen, we are near the end of this particular journey. And I want, this is a general life advice, whenever you're at the end of a journey, you gotta appreciate what we got to hear. And I want to give you a little message at the end, for the gentlemen out there. We've got to stay committed. We started as just another peasant, another slave in pre-modern Europe, and now we're Spartans. At least that's what I want you to become. Remember, the Orangutan is nearly here, and the Persians are at the gates. So we can't just give up like that guy. We gotta keep strong like this guy. And that's where we're going. And I'm bringing you with me.